I've been guarding this clover for over a week, getting laughed at for thinking that a dust speck can speak. Well, let them all laugh. I'll try not to mind, for I have found something that they'll never find. There are secrets subtly in the water, in the air, hidden planets, tiny worlds, all invisible. Not a person seems to know, not a person seems to care. There is no one who believes a thing I say. Well, I'm fairly certain at one time or other, great thinkers all feel this way.
Your hand. Kleenex. Wash that lipstick away. Show me your face, clear as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly she mourned, is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup, don't have to pretend. Suddenly Seymour is here to provide you a sweet understanding. Seymour's your friend.
Nobody ever treated me kindly. Daddy left early, Mama was poor. I'd meet a man and I'd follow him blindly. He'd snap his fingers, me I'd say sure. But suddenly Seymour, he's standing beside me.
Tell me this feeling lasts till forever. Tell me the bad times are clean washed away.
Please understand that it's still strange and frightening. To lose is like I've been, it's so hard.
Girl that's inside me, with sweet understanding,
with sweet understanding,
with sweet understanding,
with sweet understanding,
with sweet understanding. See,
there were shows and late nights, and I never heard such screaming. No, I never heard that much screaming till there was you.
Meadows,
some enchanted evening, you may see a stranger, you may see a stranger across a crowded room. Somehow you know even that somewhere you'll see her again and again. Some enchanted evening, someone may be laughing. You will hear her laughing across a crowded room. Night after night, as strange as it seems, the sound of her laughter will sing in your dreams. Who can explain it? Who can tell you why? Fools give you reason, wise men never try. Some enchanted evening, when you find your true love, when you hear her call you across a crowded room, then fly to her side and make her your own. For all through your life you may dream alone. Once you have found her, never let her go. Once you have found her, never let her go.
Miles and miles and miles of home.
or under a curse. Your life is bad. Your prospects are worse. Your wife is sighing, crying, and your uplift tree is dying. Toes graying and teeth decaying, and creditors weighing your purse. Your mood and your rope are both plenty blue. You bet that Joe had nothing on you. Don't forget that when you get to heaven, you'll be blessed. Yes, it's all for the best.
Cut the cord. Is that the man I once adored? He's nothing but knowledge.
They call you Lady Luck, but there is room for doubt. At times you have a very unladylike way of running out. You're on this date with me, the pickings have been lush, and yet before this evening is over you might give me the brush. You might forget your manners, you might refuse to stay.
this moment at the start of the second act to acknowledge a lot of the reasons why we're all here tonight, and that would have to be for Miss Michele Siano. So could everyone just give a round of applause to her? Miss Siano, you have done so much for the theater department here at Smithtown West, and you've affected the lives of all of us that are here tonight, and we figured, you know, you're retiring, and we figured we'd put together a little thing to honor you and all the work that you've done and kindness and meanness and everything in between that you have shown us over the years. So without further ado, we'll get on with the show.
Be without. Everybody ought to have a
maid. Everybody ought to have a maid.
Everybody ought to have a working girl. Everybody ought to have a lurking girl to putter around the house. Everybody ought to have a maid.
Everybody ought to have a maid.
Everybody ought to have a menial, consistently congenial, quiet as a mouse. Oh, oh, wouldn't she be delicious tidying up the dishes? Oh, oh, wouldn't she be delightful sleeping out, sleeping in? Everybody ought to have a maid.
Everybody ought to have
someone who you hire when you're short of help to offer you the sort of help you never get from a spouse. Fluttering up the stairway, shuttering up the windows, fluttering up the bedroom, buttering up the master, fluttering all around the house.
Everybody ought to have
someone who would fetch you your slipper will, be winsome as a whippoorwill, and graceful as a grouse. Skittering down the hallway, flittering through the parlor, tittering in the pantry, littering up the bedroom,
huttering all around the house.
A maid.
Have a maid.
Everybody ought to have a working girl, a loyal and observing girl, who's quieter than a mouse.
Oh, oh, think of her at the dustbin, especially when she's just been traipsing about.
Oh, oh,
delightful cleaning up,
giving out.
Everybody ought to have a maid.
Timely and collecting bits of paper and strings, appealing in her apron strings, beguiling in her blouse.
Pattering in the hallway, chattering in the cellar,
buttering in the kitchen,
clattering in the bedroom,
buttering all around the house.
Everybody ought to have a maid.
Someone who's consistent and reliable, obedient and pliable,
quiet as a mouse. Oh, oh, wouldn't she be so nimble, fiddling with her nimble, mending a gown? Oh, oh, wouldn't she be delightful? Leaning down.
Everybody ought to have a maid.
Someone who's as busy as a bumblebee, and even if you grumble, be as graceful as a grouse.
Wriggling in the anteroom,
wriggling in the living room,
wriggling in the dining room,
wiggling in the other rooms,
muttering all around the house.
You'd come. to respect my mind, and at last you'd find you could love me again. And I have turned my whole world upside down, trying not to let you go, watching you walk away is like a fatal blow. What? Is that my name up on that list? Does someone know that I exist? Is this a mistake? Am I even awake? Pinch me now to make sure. Ah! Yes, that's my name in black and white. I must be doing something right. Wow! I feel so much better than before. Warmer! Sorry, I've been a pest, but I guess my best was not working.
The curtain descends, there's nothing but loving and laughter. When the fairy tale ends,
happily, happily, happily ever after. A magical kiss counteracting the apple eventually. Though I know I'm not clever, I'll do what they tell me I have to. I want some happily ever after to happen to me. Rapunzel had platinum tresses that were double the length of her dresses. But she took them out of her clothes. By a wicked old witch. Then one night in despair down, she scrambled by letting her hair down. That's what I call quite a switch. Well, it'll never hold. I'll be finished before I begin. And besides, I don't want to get out. I want to get in. I want my happily, happily, happily ever after. I want to be happy.
We don't have any ancestors, so here's our ancestor. longer we get to gather here.
Dead for forever, from whatever, called now to reappear.
Every cadaver, start the palaver, once given Adam's here. Hold your decaying view, what we're saying, time now to hear the cheer.
Rigor mortis! Death rattle!
There's a lot of dance breaks with
that.
When you're an hour,
that's right, when you're
a very special duty.
Late night out with the
when
other.
You're an Alex,
one bite,
you're obligated to the clan. It's family first and family last and family by and by. When you're an Alex, the standard is just don't apply. When you're an Alex,
regarding love and art. Why, I'd be friends with the sparrows and the boy that shoots the arrows if I only had a heart. Oh, I'd be in my shrine, king down to the core. I could roar the way I never roared before, and then I'd woof and roar some more. I would show the dinosaurs who's king around the forest a king they better serve. And why, with my regal beezer, I could be another Caesar if I only had the nerve.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. We hear he is a wizard of ways, if ever a wiz there was. If ever, oh, ever a wiz there was, the Wizard of Oz is one. Because of the wonderful things he does. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
So No. I just might make it. Hey, Mom. Can't believe you're finally retiring. It's, like, pretty wild to think that you started this whole adventure when I was only 9 years old, and now it's got a little mustached young man who's awaiting your first grandchild. So it's crazy to think that I was watching the earliest shows, and there was all those like big kids and walking through Smithtown West, and just being like, oh wow, it's like what high school's like. And then, you know, now I think like decades later that I was comparing like your shows and everything against the shows that I would do at Harbor Fields and in college and everything, all that. So, you know, every year you really did push yourself. You went a little bit harder with it, rolled with little punches. And, you know, it was always funny when February came around and Sean and I would just know that, you know, it'd be a lot of late nights for you, and especially with Hell Week and everything that went with that. But you always somehow were able to work with everybody, pull it together, and you know, it really showed me what came from your dedication.
It's so great to be here tonight in your honor. We all feel the same way. When I think of you, I think of some very famous, beautiful songs. The first one being by the father-daughter team, Yakin Cole, Yami Cole, Unforgettable. That's what you are to all of us for so many different reasons, and they're all good. You are our brown-eyed girl, and we all love you. Many of your students, past and present, and colleagues, will think of the words of Elvis's song, The Wonder of You. You give them hope and inspiration. You gave them strength to carry on, no matter what their challenge was, whether academically or personally. You gave them the strength to carry on. You inspired them, and that was wonderful. Now, with the new baby coming along, that is just one of the greatest things that can happen to you. That's going to be beyond words beautiful. But we also want to coin a phrase from the Eagles, and we want you to take it easy, but we want to let the good times roll, and we want you to take a page from Cindy, and girl, just go and have fun. And last but not least, from that very famous old Blue Eyes, you did it your way, and you did it awesome. Love you.
Lighting booth and the house, jumping up and down, yelling at us to sing louder. That voice is burned in my brain forever in the best way possible. I remember you making me stand up on a chair to sing during Godspell in 2010 because I was finding my voice, and somehow standing on that chair was going to help me project. And I don't understand the science, but it kind of worked. I remember that you refused to sign my yearbook in 2012 because it would be a goodbye and you weren't saying goodbye. And most of all, I remember your hugs and your humor, during those hard teenage years. I'm happy that we're still in touch, and I feel so honored to have been your student. Congratulations on your retirement. No one deserves it more than you. Love you.
I think the play Hello Dolly is amazing. It's creative, it's innovative, and the best part of the whole deal is that you have all kinds of kids as part of it. Everybody from special education, life skills, right up to the advanced placement classes. And there's no other content area, and there's nothing else we do in this school that encompasses all children.
Hey, Siano. Congratulations on your retirement. You are such an important part of my high school experience, and you've played such a big role in so many people's lives. I hope you realize how big an impact you've had on all of us, and I wish you all the best in your next chapter. Congratulations again, good luck, and thank you for everything.
Congratulations on your retirement. As I said in my note to you, I cannot think of someone who has both looked forward to this day more or deserves it. You truly have been such a light for this community and have impacted the lives of every single one of your students. I love you so very much, and I still think about you every single day. I truly cherish my time at Smithtown, and I wish you the best in your next chapter. I love you.
Blood, sweat, and tears, and love that it's the way it is. I'm going to miss you. I love you so much.
I was always in awe, you know, being able to see just really what you were able to put together, you know. It was always incredible, just seeing what you were able to produce and put your vision and everything and heart into it. And it always cracked me up whenever you would get called up on stage to accept the flowers and you'd do your little weird shoulder thing and your weird headlight stuff. And you're just always so awkward with the limelight, but you know, you always had such a good heart with it, Mom. So, but you know, it's really no wonder that you're surrounded with so much love. I know everyone in the room. You'll probably share with a lot of stories about your unique brand of spicy, genuine kindness, you know, how you're able to move mountains with your mania, and that you're really just one of the most selfless people that I know all of us have ever met. Get a grip, go take a shower, and my darling, you are an asshole. Are definitely three phrases that you never know how to use all the time. I'm sure a lot of your former students feel the same. But I'm just so proud to know that you've touched so many lives. You're such an impactful person, Mom, and you're absolutely the greatest mom I could ever have asked for. And I'm so thankful that I was able to share your kindness and who you are with so many different young people. And I really hope that I'll be the parent that you were to me for my child. So excited to see Mama Shelley become Grandmama Shelley in the future here. So I love you, Mom.
We love you.
So much to us to be able to honor such an incredible woman in this way. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Allie. I had the privilege of choreographing Wizard of Oz in 2019 and choreographing and co-directing Crazy for You in 2020. As a freshman in 2011, I went to see Thoroughly Modern Millie, and I've been fortunate enough to see every single Smithtown High School West musical since. Whether I was there supporting my friends who were in the cast and crew, or later as a member of the production staff, one thing was abundantly clear. This room is home to so much more than a stage and a light and soundboard. It's home to a family that spans two decades of high school students, and we have Miss Siano to thank for that. She made sure that every member of the cast, crew, and pit felt like they belonged in the production. Over the 18 years, she has given everything she could to each and every musical. From making sure everyone is fed on long nights with homemade chicken and smashed potatoes, to organizing costumes, to playing house as she dressed the sets, and so much more, these productions would not have happened without her hard work. But Siano taught us so much more than just how to put on a show. She taught us how to take pride in our work and how to go above and beyond for the people we care about. The lessons we learned in this room have made us truly better people. I'm so lucky to have gotten to play a small role in the story of this theater department, and it's all because of her. Siano, thank you for trusting me when you had no evidence that I knew how to choreograph a musical. You taught me so much about how to build a production, and you believed in me, even when I didn't believe in myself. You let me experiment and try things, which sometimes worked out really well, and other times led to me and Matt screwing a platform directly into the stage. There were moments when I really didn't know if I could pull it off, but watching those two productions come together are some of my proudest accomplishments, and I couldn't have done it if you didn't have faith in me and weren't there to support me every step of the way. When I found out that Siano was retiring, I knew I wanted to find a way to honor her time, effort, and dedication to West's theater department. What better way to do that than to reunite the family she had created? I want to take a second to thank everyone who helped make this night possible. Thank you to everyone who took the stage tonight to bring back some of the magic of the last 20 years, and to all the alumni sitting in the audience for coming to celebrate with us. Thank you to everyone who helped run front of house. I want to give a special thank you to my mom, who despite having her youngest daughter graduate in 2019, can never seem to escape this auditorium or the chaos it brings to her house. I want to thank Ethan and Ryan for coming on board to help with the planning and organization of the showcase. Thank goodness Matt and I had people who have actually performed on the stage and could read music to help us out. And of course, the biggest thank you goes to Matt Kelly, or as I like to call him, the mayor of Smithtown. When I brought the idea of the showcase to him on one late night trip to the Millennium Diner, he was immediately on board, and I definitely couldn't have made this a reality without him. Matt, thank you for making this happen tonight, for being by my side during Crazy for You, and for all the many things you've done over the years as Siano's right-hand man. And finally, thank you, Siano. Your dedication to this theater department has left a legacy like no other. You've touched the lives of so many students over your years here, and we can't even begin to imagine what our time at West would have looked like without you. We would all be different people without you in our lives. Both in the classroom and out, you've touched the lives of countless students, only a fraction of which are standing on this stage with me today. Thank you for pouring your heart and soul into everything you do and for showing us how to be kind, dedicated, thoughtful people. Congratulations on your retirement. And now, Mr. Brosnan.
Dead man.
Michele, you were the first teacher I met in this building when I transferred over here 10 years ago. And one of the first things that you ever said to me was, "Don't worry, you'll get used to me." It took a little bit of time for us to get used to working together, but I did. Each of the 8 shows that we produced together were a wild ride in and of themselves. And each of those 8 shows are filled with so many wonderful memories of getting to put them together with you. Over the course of each of those shows, you would say to me countless times, "I don't know what I'm doing. I just tell them to go up there and be great." You didn't need to be well-versed in all the intricacies of musical theater to have a profound impact on every single student that came across this stage. What you might not have known about choreography, musical direction, or stage direction, you more than made up for with your knowledge of how to put people in the best situations to be successful. You're an expert at finding the right people for the right job at the right time and making all the pieces work together. And that's really what this entire experience is all about. Most of all, you knew the most important part of this job, which is that the kids were always the most important thing. Every show that we did together, you and I disagreed about so many different things. But we always came back to, it has to be what's best for the kids. Last year's production of Into the Woods, my first without you, came out beautifully, and we had a great time putting it together, but even though the production did very well and was a great experience for everyone involved, it wasn't the same. And I don't think it ever will be. I miss so many things about working together with you to put these productions together, from late night family meals and crew calls to agonizing over the cast list, to arguing about which kids need vocal rest, to watching the previews and opening night together. I will not miss you sitting behind me in the next row in the auditorium watching rehearsals and screaming right in my ear when you saw something you didn't like. I also won't miss it when you smack me in the head for something that wasn't my fault. Yes, it is. It really didn't hit me until the night of the final dress rehearsal of Into the Woods last year that this experience was going to be forever different for me. You see, you may not realize it, Michele, but you had a habit of doing the same thing after every final dress rehearsal. Every single year after the final dress, we do the bows with the kids, and then we give notes to the cast, we'd send everyone home. And after everyone had left and you and I were the only ones left in the auditorium, you would take a deep breath and you would stand up and you'd say, "Okay, time to clean up, we're having company tomorrow." It was such a small thing, almost a throwaway line. I'm not even sure if you know that you said it, but you said it every year. And to me, that was always a signal that our work had been completed and that the show was no longer ours and it belonged to the kids. This year, after the final dress, the cast put their stuff away, the pit packed up, the crew set the stage for the previews, everyone kind of trickled out of the room. I was wrapping lighting cables in the back of the room, and I looked up to realize I was alone. And it hit me, because you were always the last one to leave. You'd never let any of us stay and work without you. You would never let any of us stay here by ourselves. You always stayed until the last person had left. This was the first time I was wrapping up on my own. So I took a breath and I said, "Time to clean up. We're having company tomorrow." As you walk away from your teaching career into the next chapter of your life and away from this beautiful and robust program that you built, please know that it's in good hands, that it's well cared for, and that the kids will still always be the most important thing. From my heart to yours, thank you for sharing your program, your dedication, and your love of these kids with me. Congratulations and best wishes in your retirement.
And I'm a bigger dead man. Siano, ladies and gentlemen, family, friends, and the High School West School community. Today is a day of celebration, recognition, and a heartfelt appreciation as we gather to honor a truly extraordinary individual who has dedicated an incredible 18 years of her life to the Smithtown West Theater Program. Ms. Michele Siano, our director and producer,
Your passion, dedication, and unwavering commitment has been the driving force behind the success of our musical productions, shaping the lives of many students along the way. Your vision and creativity has brought to life stories and characters that have touched the hearts of all students and audiences alike. The magic you have created on stage will continue to resonate for years to come. Through your leadership, you have instilled in us the value of hard work, discipline, teamwork, and the importance of pursuing our passions. As we reflect on the countless hours, sleepless nights, and the tireless effort you've poured heart and soul into this program, and we can't help to be in awe of your love for the arts and your students. You've not only been a director and a producer, but a mentor, a friend, a cook, a motherly figure, and a source of inspiration to all who had the privilege of working with you. Your legacy is not confined to the classroom or the productions we've seen on this stage. It's woven into the fabric of our school, and it's a testament to the love and passion you have shared with all of us. My first year as a student in Smithtown was in 10th grade. It was a rough adjustment, but you were one of my guiding lights. You helped me come out of my shell and shape me into who I am today. Remembering back to sophomore year, Legally Blonde, I was so shy. To junior year, Once Upon a Mattress, where I came out on stage in that green ugly dress. To senior year, Adam's Family, where I went out on stage to clean grandma's pee. After graduating, having the opportunity to return to West and be a part of your production team for The Wizard of Oz, Crazy for You, Songs for a New World, and 9 to 5. I became your right hand, left leg, and always right in your ear, telling you who each person was and whose parent that was. We had some very exciting moments together, from being my Mrs. Claus for the winter concerts, to the late work nights during Hell Week, our family dinners, to greeting our senior citizens and the red hat ladies, to our yellow paint situation, all over the stage and the parking lot and wherever it was. To you falling off the stage into the pit, to Sam, Allie, and I screwing a platform to the stage. You teaching me about hospitality and the use of doilies. Going on Costco and Home Depot runs. To set decorating and making sure everything was symmetrical. To all the crazy costumes, outfits, and eye patches. Even from a hospital room, calling and texting you reminders of things that needed to get done. This showcase here is a Mr. Holland opus moment for a teacher. There's not a life in this room that you have not touched, and each of us is a better person because of you. As you transition into your retirement, we know that you will bring the same energy and creativity to your new adventures. We wish you all the success and happiness you so richly deserve. I would like to thank my production team, Allie, Ryan, Ethan, Mr. B, my co-stage managers, Meg and Ani, the High School West stage crew, and to Siano's family for keeping it a secret so long, who's here in the first row. Thank you for your dedication to making this night happen. It's been a long few months planning and logistically, but we pulled it off. Thank you to all the alumni that have returned to the stage and joined forces with our current students to dedicate and honor Siano. Siano, on behalf of all the students, actors, crew members, and musicians whose lives you have touched, we want to express our deepest gratitude for your incredible dedication and the profound impact you had had on each and every one of us. You will always have a special place in our hearts and in the history of the Smithtown West Theater Department. We will miss you, and we will forever be grateful for your extraordinary contributions. Congratulations and best wishes. Now it's time for you to do your little shoulder thing and mosey your way up to the stage.
Mr. Mayor, on behalf of New York State Senator Marion Matera and Suffolk County Clerk Vincent Puglio, I present you with certificates of appreciation for your 18 years of dedication to the Smithtown West Theater Department and community. I present to you the Standing Ovation Award, honoring Ms. Siano in grateful appreciation for 18 years of dedication to the Smithtown West Theater Department. Love, all of us. We just went out to dinner at Old Street about 2 hours ago. And, let's go to the fundraiser. Let's see, let's support the drama and the musical. And here we are. I created a program special for you with all messages from everyone through the years. Thank you for teaching me how to make a program. All right, one more page. Because I knew you, I have been changed for good. It's rare to find a person who gives their time so effortlessly and who's willing to put on... It's rare to find a person who gives their time so effortlessly, who is willing to put in their all into something over and over again, and still be so passionate and dedicated. Ms. Siano is that person. For 18 years, she poured everything she can into building a theater program. She and every person, whoever's been involved, could be proud of. She pushed us to find our voices and create 18 years of truly incredible performances. There really was nothing more special than finally getting her laugh when we nailed that line, or when the tough love finally paid off and the scene clicked. What we've gathered together to honor and recognize tonight it isn't the show she's put on, but the love and care she has gave to every single cast and crew over those 18 years. Siano was more than a director and a producer. She was a friend, a mentor, and a mom. And we went to her for help with everything from economics homework to life advice. We've learned endless lessons, some of which we have not... may have been school appropriate. Walking into the Smithtown West Auditorium has felt like coming back home in a safe place where everyone belonged. We could never really thank her for everything she has done and the impact she's left on the community. We're honored to gather alumni all the way from Little Shops to 9 to 5 and take the stage again to honor Seattle's legacy. To close this evening, I would like to call up everyone who has performed here tonight for one last song to Miss Siano, a true luminary in the High School West Theater Department and in our hearts.
Because you will become, you will try, you'll do. But each of you have given me the gift of that every teacher should experience, and unfortunately they don't. Every one of you have given me you in some special way. Either the nights we spent here, the jokes, the smacks in your head. But each of you have given me something. And in teaching, the gift that a teacher could have. The greatest gift a teacher could have is this. So I thank you. I thank each and every one of you for making my career worthwhile, giving meaning to my career. Because without you guys, this job would suck. Thank you. And thank you to all of you, because all of you gave me the opportunity to be with your children as a family, ours. But I gotta say, thank you to each and every one of you when the community didn't like so much what we did. Right? But the parents, all of you, have always been so supportive of me, Bea, Christy, Cassara, all of us together as a team, and we could not have done that without the families and you guys. You know? Thank you. I sound like a movie. And my custodian guys. I have to thank them also, big time, for the nights that we were all here and we didn't go down. But I'm so humble right now. I didn't even know this was happening. How could the whole school keep a secret from me?
Surprised?
Yes.
What do you think of the show?
Honest.
What do you think of the show?
I think the show is fabulous. I mean, every song, every play, I'm humbled.
Congratulations.
I'm really humbled. Thank you. You know.